Hi, this is Dr. Homer Lim, and you're listening to your Holistic Health Podcast. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our weekly talk here at Akesis Holistic Health. So today, our topic will be on hyperbaric oxygen, okay? Now, hyperbaric oxygen therapy, actually, we do not have that therapy. We do recommend it because it really works and it really helps on a lot of our patients, especially if they had had chemotherapy or radiotherapy, or you know they have some kind of bone pain. So usually would recommend them to do hyperbaric oxygen therapy. So what is hyperbaric oxygen therapy? So when we say hyperbaric, meaning hyper, meaning above or higher, no? Hyper. So when we say baric, hyperbaric meaning more than the normal pressure of oxygen in our air. Normally, our air is around 21% oxygen. Okay, so when you say hyperbaric oxygen therapy, what you're going to do is you're going to go into this chamber. Okay, so this chamber will then introduce what we call 100% oxygen. So instead of the ordinary 21% oxygen that you're breathing, okay, in our atmosphere, when you're in this chamber, it's 100%. So it's totally 100% oxygen. Okay, now further than that, what's more important is it creates this pressure. It puts pressure. So the more air, you have more pressure. So normally we put patients when they're hyperbaric oxygen, we start them on what we talk about atmospheres or number of feet underwater, because that's how you measure pressure. So normally when you are in an hyperbaric oxygen, it's measured either in atmospheres or how deep under, meaning it could be 15, 30 feet, 60 feet, depending on the situation. Okay, so hyperbaric oxygen chamber or therapy started when this was more popularized when a lot of divers would develop what we call the bends. No, that's when they suddenly, when they're deep down in the water, okay, underwater, they're very deep, and suddenly they accidentally or for some reason they immediately go up without really acclimatizing or equalizing the pressures of oxygen in their body. So say they develop what we call the Caisson's disease or bends. So then when this happens, then you have to go to a hyperbaric chamber, and what this does is it retries to slowly bring up the, lessen the pressure of oxygen, because when you're in deep underwater, the amount of oxygen in the body becomes very, very high. That's because, of course, the pressure. So when you go suddenly up, then suddenly there would be some of them develop what we call, some form of air bubble. So how do you avoid this, or how do you treat this? They go into a hyperbaric oxygen chamber. So, but in cancer treatment, hyperbaric oxygen chamber is therapy wherein we are trying to push more oxygen into the cancer tissues, okay? As you might already know, cancer cells live in a oxygen poor, okay? Meaning less oxygen poor environment. So when we introduce oxygen, when you try to push oxygen, not only into the tissue, but the whole body, the cancer cells will behave differently. They become more sensitive to other treatments, whether it's vitamin C, chemotherapy, radiotherapy. For some reasons, the cancer cells become more sensitive to them because they do not like too much oxygen. Okay, but there are, of course, some exceptions to cancer cells having problems or having issues with oxygen supply. But in general, especially those big, large tumors, no? Big, large tumors, usually at the very middle, okay, or the center of the tumor, have very low amounts of oxygen. So when you introduce hyperbaric oxygen chamber, the cancer cells will start becoming more sensitive to other therapies. So that's one way of helping. How we do is we combine hyperbaric oxygen chamber with our IV therapies, and we found a very, very good response. Usually patients, when they're doing hyperbaric oxygen chamber, after 3 or 4 sessions of vitamin C or whatever vitamin therapies or radiotherapy, they notice an improvement, no? It's, you know, whether it's less pain, more energy, sleep better. So these are some of the things that we note when they are doing hyperbaric oxygen therapy, no? Or what we call HBOT, no? So when we do recommend, we don't really ask them to go on a daily hyperbaric or HBOT therapy. What we would just recommend would be probably 2 or 3 times a week. Because of course, if you do it every day, it also becomes tiring, no? So a session would last around more or less about an hour from the initial, what we call when they go down deeper, they call it deeper or going into higher atmospheric pressure, okay? Now, what are the dangers? I think one of the things that, you know, a lot of patients are worried about is danger of hyperbaric since they're going to go into this chamber, no? If you are what we call claustrophobic, no? So you're afraid of small spaces, that might be an issue, okay? But in general, hyperbaric oxygen chamber is quite safe, okay? So the only patients who are who should not go doing hyperbaric are those with, number one, they have sinus issues, okay? Meaning their sinuses are clogged. If they have a lung, what we call pulmonary blebs, they have little bubbles in their chest, in their lungs, no? Then you cannot do a hyperbaric, because when you do hyperbaric, sometimes it will pop and you will develop what we call a pneumothorax. So one of the things that we require patients before they do HBOT is a chest x-ray just to see that the lungs are clear, there are no what we call pulmonary blebs, okay? So these are, you know, some of the things. That's, I think, number one is pulmonary blebs. And then, of course, if you have sinus issue, you have colds, you know, it's not good to do a hyperbaric because it might cause severe pain on your head, especially your sinuses. So these are the things that we watch out for prior to doing hyperbaric oxygen therapy or HBOT, what we call it, HBOT, no? So there are many centers for what we call HBOT, and there are also many kinds of HBOTs. So there's what we call a one person, okay? One person chamber. There's also multi-chambers. We call it multi-chambers, wherein you can fit, you know, 6, 8, 12 people in one sitting, no? There are also, in fact, there are even hyperbaric chambers for animals, for dogs. So that's interesting. So these hyperbaric oxygen chambers are located, you know, in, there are in Makati, there's one in Quezon City, there's one in Mandaluyong, several actually in Quezon City, I think 2 or 3, because some big hospitals do have hyperbaric oxygen therapy also. But of course, the cost will be a bit different, no? So normally, we do recommend patients to get at least 10 sessions of hyperbaric just to see if, you know, it really helps. If it really helps, then they continue to do the hyperbaric oxygen chamber together with IV therapies, because we found out that when we do hyperbaric oxygen therapy together with IV drips, you know, you supercharge your IV therapies, they become much, much more effective in delivering vitamins, the minerals, as well as cancer cells become more sensitive to all these therapies, okay? So again, for those who are interested in hyperbaric oxygen therapy, you can search hyperbaric oxygen therapy. We don't have hyperbaric oxygen therapy here at Akesis, so we usually would refer them outside. Okay? Thank you for listening to your Holistic Health Podcast. This is Dr. Homer Lim. Now, if you do have questions about your health, or you would like to request topics for our next podcast, please do message us at our FB page or Instagram at Akesis Holistic Health, or you may visit our website at www.akesisholistic.com. Thank you again, and please do come back for our next episodes.